previous video, we went through all the math of one-way ANOVA, and now we can talk about how we summarize it. So lots of times we'll summarize it in what's called an ANOVA table here. And the way it works is we have a column for the source of variability, a column for the sum of squares, a column for the degrees of freedom, a column for the mean squares, and then finally our test statistic. All right, so remember that we have the treatment, sum of squares, and the SSE, because we have two sources of error, two sources of variability, the treatment and the error. All right, so then we, in the next column, have our degrees of freedom. So this is the number of populations, or number of groups, minus one, and then this is the overall sample size minus the number of groups. All right, so when we look at the total, this total will add. So remember, the total sum of squares is equal to SST plus SSE. Similarly, the total degrees of freedom equals n minus 1, which is m minus 1 plus n minus m. All right, so sum of squares and degrees of freedom add. And once we get to the next column, these no longer add. So here in this next column, we have the mean squares. So MST is just SST divided by m minus 1. So we just take this column, divide by that column. Similarly for MSE, we take this column, divide by that column. So it's pretty easy as long as we organize it this way. It's super easy to remember what how to calculate mean squares. And then finally, when we get to our test statistic, remember that's just MST divided by MSE. So again, that's pretty easy. We just look at this column, take this value, divide by that value, and that's our test statistic. Okay, so remember under the null hypothesis, that test statistic has an F distribution with m minus 1 degrees of freedom and n minus m degrees of freedom. And remember, the larger the test set is, the more evidence we have against the null hypothesis. So here I've drawn our F distribution with m minus 1 and n minus m degrees of freedom. And then here marked is our test statistic, MST over MSE. And then the p-value is just the area to the right of that.